We talk increasingly about humanoid robots, robotics broadly on this program. You are working on the software side,
yes,
not the hardware side.
Correct.
Just explain the approach of Covariant.
So what Covariant is building is really the GBT of robotics. So think about it as the general purpose brain that can sit behind any robotics hardware that gives it the ability to see the world, think about what's happening around it, and make decisions intelligently. And this is a big contrast with traditional robotics, which is really programming robots to do the same thing again and again, which just doesn't cut it in today's warehouse environment, manufacturing environments, where you have constant changes that are coming in. And the unique Covariant approach here is we don't just build a single specific AI that can solve one task. We are really approaching it in the similar manner that, for example, like large language model is approaching chatbot, other language
right.
applications. It's a single model powering multiple use cases.
But here's the thing, that you don't control the hardware side, right? Take Tesla as a comparison. I don't know your thoughts on the Optimus program, but they are developing both the hardware and the software. They obviously have Dojo that they're working on in-house. What are the risks and benefits of just focusing on software if you're not too also doing purpose-built hardware to match it?
Yeah, so first of all, on Optimus, we think it's an amazing robotics program. Like, it's a really great humanoid hardware that is being built, being iterated very quickly. From a Covariant perspective, we believe there's not a single hardware form factor that would rule robotics to come, because the physical world is very diverse. Like, there's not going to be a single software, a single hardware that rules it all. And we believe there are going to be multiple kinds of robot hardwares, some in the humanoid form factors, some in the industrial arm form factors, some with maybe mobile robot with a manipulator on top of it. And all of these different hardware form factors still need to make sense of the same physical world. And Covariant is building exactly that, the same brain that can power multiple kinds of hardware to make sense of the physical world.
So, Peter, talk to us about the inputs here. How hard, what are the intricacies you need to go about building what is the largest data set ever to train this new robotics foundation model?
That's an amazing question. So we have seen the explosive success of large language model, and what is really behind its amazing generalization power is the fact that it's trained on the whole internet of text. And if you want to build a robot AI that is as smart as, for example, large language model, but in the physical world, you also need to build the same kind of data set, but there's no internet to scrape in this case. So you need to deploy a large fleet of robots into the world, doing diverse and dynamic things, and collecting the video data, images data, robot actions, and the outcome of those robot actions in order to really train a model that understands the world in all kinds of settings and be robust even in the rare long-tail scenarios and truly deliver a human-level performance to our customers.
And the reason you've been able to get such a wide, varied underlying data set is because of the amount of countries you're in, the amount of companies you're already working with. Can you just give us an idea of where this model is already being applied? How are we starting to see it in our everyday lives?
Yeah, so we have already deployed the Covariant AI to more than dozens of customers in more than 10 countries, and they are powering the warehouse operations, the e-commerce fulfillment operations in a lot of places. So very likely, like if you have order an item, for example, during Black Friday, there's a really good chance that that item has been touched by one of the Covariant's robots that's operating around the world.
Peter, very quick, we have 10 seconds. Your favorite use case for the robotics you're working on?
My favorite use case for the new robotics foundation model, RFM1, is really the ability to talk to it. Instead of robots that are just rigidly doing the same thing again and again, we now have the ability to communicate with robots in natural language. Very similar to how you would talk to ChatGPT or Gemini in natural language and ask it questions, really democratizing access to AI for a lot of people. We're really doing the same with robotics with RFM1.